Hey y'all, what's going on? Just wanted to pop in here again. Just want to briefly speak a little bit more, not on that particular Eddie Long situation, but more so about the church and the ideas that people have about the church. I don't know. I mean, and I can't even say, because I used to think this way, like, oh, nothing, once you step into those four walls, like, it's like it's a whole new world. Like, nothing happens. Like, you know, people don't lie. People don't backstab. People don't this. But I came to a real rude awakening that when I stepped inside those doors, what I left out there is the same thing I'm stepping into. It may be a little bit more not in your face, but it still exists. I think people hide behind religion. Hide behind the Bible. See, that's where the difference comes in. There's like, you know, we're supposed to put on this, you know, the shield. Sandy, stop it. Arm ourselves with the word and with the power. But I think we arm ourselves for the wrong reasons to hide those things which we do face. And that's why we're not honest with each other. That's why, you know, if a young woman gets pregnant in the church, it's like, it's shame. That's why if someone has I'm not going to use a regular illness. Let's use a sexually transmitted disease. It's kept on the hush because, well, again, it's shame. I mean, that happens outside in the world as well. But I'm saying in a place where we should be able to, a place where we should be able to come together and share and encourage and uplift each other, it doesn't happen that way. And then when stuff like the example with, you know, Bishop Eddie Long, whether it happened or not, this, you don't have to be him, because it happens in the church. Look at the Catholic Church. Look at, it happens. Nothing exists. I don't understand why people think that just because, you know, a person is in some rank or just in the church period that they don't do anything. It's such a lie. It's like, it's not saying that there aren't, nobody walks the earth without anything. No one is perfect. Just that, you know, if you have someone who's a pedophile, it's someone who's a liar, someone who's a murderer. Guess what? We all in the same boat. Somebody said, oh, how could you say a pedophile is the same thing as a liar? If you want to take it back to the church, and if we're all supposed to be following this word, this doctrine, there is no sin greater than the other. We are the people that make them higher, lower. Like, you know, oh my God, a pedophile is worse than a liar. We do that. Now, again, when I say I'm not surprised, it's not saying that he did it or he did not. I'm not surprised because I don't put anything past anybody. There's a whole, I mean, look at, let's take it on to the world. Let's look at the presidents. Let's look at, Clinton, you know. No, I did not have sexual relations. She got a blowjob, okay? Him being president and having a family, did that exempt him from, you know, from having sexual relations with someone? Nothing. People don't put things past anybody. I look at it like this. If I'm capable of doing it and thinking it, why isn't the next person? And then, you know, what pisses me off, the whole thing with the church, and then, you know, when they interview, you know, everyone's like, oh my Lord, I can't believe you did it. Oh my Lord. And y'all the same people that probably talk about him. Yes, I said it. It's just, y'all the same people that probably talk. I've seen it. I've experienced it. The same people that would be like, oh no, not the brother. It's the same people that would sit around the dining room table and talk about them. So I say all this to say, stop the nonsense, people. Stop trying to think that people are above anything. And you want, it's not a good thing to think that, oh, there's no good people in the world. But don't think that anybody is incapable of the capable. That makes sense, yeah. That's all I had to say anyway. Y'all be good to yourselves and each other. Peace, y'all.